When we mention farmers working together in a pragmatic way with CEOs, then we mean farmers or foresters that are open to practicing carbon agroforest practices, which we claim to be 100 times more productive, amongst others in produced biomass. This compared to traditional agriculture, simply because a carbon agroforest has 100 times more producing biomass. Much higher effectiveness and leaf area than traditional agriculture has. So in this proposal, in a way traditional farmers will cease to be traditional farmers and become carbon agroforesters, or farmers foresters. Obviously these farmers that change their practices and will harvest 100 times more biomass and or products, will encounter challenges in their activities, and or will need assistance from lightweight robots or drones, especially while continuously working or continuously harvesting in the canopies of the also present trees, which could reach heights of well over 50 meters. The medium robot should be lightweight, and mass-produced, possibly printed, assembled and or manufactured inside the carbon agroforest, and much cheaper than for instance a traditional chainsaw, a shredder, a forager, and only cost a fraction of the most basic of agricultural machines, which all will become redundant. The robots in this case are not humanoid robots, and not at all human-like or replacing. The robots in this case are intended to complement human work in rather inconvenient or possibly dangerous tasks. Large, expensive, and soil-compacting agricultural machines become redundant. By the way, no traditional chainsaws, foragers, tractors, plows, and not even shredders will be used in carbon agroforests. Further, a medium robot would work silently, be able to handle a wide variety of tasks, like pruning, harvesting, transport and much more, and would be able to cooperate with other robots, eventually could work day and night and all days of the year. These are amongst the main reasons why the farmers foresters most probably will need to work rather closely together with certain CEOs, that eventually will develop and produce all or the bulk of the for carbon agroforests almost essential robots and or drones. Even though we believe and want to warn that robots will be essential to solve all our challenges, including our climate challenges, the number of farmers foresters in the world will be at least 10 times more than the present day number of farmers plus foresters. But as said, their output together with the robots will be 100 times more and of an extremely wider variety than what traditional farmers foresters can manage as output. Polluting petrochemical industry ports will become redundant. Instead of dominantly producing crops, carbon agroforests apart from producing crops for humans and animals, also, and in fact much more, will produce fuels, and energy, but also basic materials, for the then radically transformed and decentralized and non-polluting petrochemical industry. The here mentioned non-polluting industry replacing all industries, including the petrochemical industry, will exclusively have as input renewable and organic materials, and exclusively produce renewable and organic materials and products. This is why these alternative industries that replace the traditional petrochemical industry can be decentralized and eventually, or rather preferentially, fully integrated inside the carbon agroforest area. Polluting petrochemical industry ports will become redundant and inefficient compared to the decentralized carbon agroforest-based alternative industry or industries. This is the subject of other videos. In fact, all the carbon agroforest non-polluting all industries replacing industries will replace all industries, and produce amongst many others all gasoline, fuels and energies, alternatives for plastics or renewable plastic likes. Further, these will produce all of the more advanced materials like graphene, silicon, rare metals and rare earth metals. All these surprising productions and the needed processes are subjects of other videos. Further, close to 100% of these farmers foresters will work remotely from their homes across the planet, mostly assisting the robots working in the carbon agroforests, maybe somehow comparable with the assistance in certain cases of autonomous or driverless taxicabs. This combination of farmers foresters with robots will make large, expensive, and soil-compacting agricultural machines redundant. These farmers foresters will also make roads, as well as inter-row spacing or the so-called tramlines like in agricultural regions, totally disnecessary. Agricultural regions, especially those in tropics and subtropics, could look quite similar to non-degenerated tropical forests, and in fact could look like the Amazon forest after becoming mature. Ideally, large agricultural regions and properties will be commonly fenced off as a whole, pretty much like some wild reserves. Fencing per property makes no sense. Markings of the limits are optional. Natural predators, like for instance jaguars in South America, typical for certain tropical forests, should be expected, or rather will be kind of unavoidable. A wide variety of wild animals could or will also play an important role as seed dispersers. Altogether, it won't be at all a typical rural area. Since we are not talking about forest areas, but about agricultural areas, we think it would be perfectly ethically and correct to control the numbers of wild animals in the now modified agricultural areas, that is if controlling the numbers of wild animals was necessary and chosen for. In the case that predators would be allowed, all farmers foresters working in the field need to be prepared and dispose of the eventually necessary protection. Expect certain wild animals in the carbon agroforests to have plain interest in interacting with the robots in certain cases. This and other videos on this channel have been translated and or dubbed into more than 5 languages, including the official languages of the 9 Amazonian countries, this to support this initiative and plan to unite the 8 billion inhabitants of the planet around this action plan for carbon agroforestry, generating important jobs and boosting the economy. If you'd also like to support this initiative, subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, ask a question, or like this video.